1, 2, 3, 4. We'll be right back. Pleasure to welcome back to the studio Admiral Sir Cloudesley Shovell.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hooray.
Hurrah.
Here they all are in their marvellousness.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, people.
Looking beautiful as ever.
So thanks for playing for us today. Excellent stuff. A lot of songs from the new album.
Yep. In fact, all bar one.
It's been a pleasure.
No, it's cool. Real good fun, man. It's a lot of fun indeed.
Excellent.
A good time.
Sunday session, that was lovely.
Cool. And how's it going, the new record? It's been out for a short while, is it?
A couple of weeks. 2 weeks it's been out, something like that, more or less.
Two weeks tomorrow.
Cool.
Seems to be going okay.
Just literally come back off tour as well.
Indeed.
Yeah, yes. four dates with Uncle Acid and the Deadbeats and Black Moth up and down the country. That was all good fun, sold out venues. Yeah, it was
good.
Excellent. It was good. A lot of fun. Opening up and all that. We had a good time.
Excellent stuff. And there's a couple of videos as well, isn't there, online from the new record?
They've got The Thicker The Better.
I think they've got the single
Elementary Man.
Yeah. Which is both done by our friend Mark Richards, who's a Wiz for Girl video.
He knows his stuff, knows his onions.
They're both good. Thicker The Better's strange. He's
a bit random.
He's stupid enough to put our sick ideas onto
film.
Onto film, yeah. We'd make it up as we go along and he films this.
Crazy, isn't it?
We had a whole bunch of fun doing that. There was a lot of
drinking,
boozing, bit of sex.
Who was doing the sex? Oh, the
you remember that bit? The bit at the end. Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Because of course you do know people see this. It's not really incriminating sex.
Exactly, yeah. No, it's not. It was only feature film sex. It wasn't real sex.
Did not happen.
Allegedly.
Vegetable soup, man. You think?
Yeah. It was carrot soup. Yeah.
Never tried that. I'll give it a shot.
Stunt dog at the end. Go and watch the video after you finish watching this interview. Watch the video on YouTube.
Very entertaining stuff.
Very good, kids.
Cool. So check them before you reckon. Your second LP, is that
that's right?
Right?
Yeah,
on
that's right.
Rise Above.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, second one.
And it was recorded here in this very sort of hallowed.
In this actual studio at that actual time.
If you like the first one, you'll love this one even more because it's better. No, it's more of the same. Only even better songs. More stuff going on. Yeah. Same style, same energy, but just better sound and better.
Much better.
Feel
to it, definitely.
Yeah, generally better songs, and also I think you can. It's more of a. you know, you can it stands up to many repeated listenings rather than just being a full on burst of energy like the first one. But the first one you play it and it's like bang.
Yeah.
And then you probably don't listen to it a bit, but this one you just want to keep hearing because there's so many good little bits going on.
Captain Merryweather.
We'll be right back.
Because with a band like yours, it's so much about the energy you get when you play live as well.
Yeah, it can be very hard to translate that into a studio.
Exactly.
But as I say, from the get-go down here, we just, I think we actually used the first take of the first song we played through, which was Shake Your Head, which was the first one we tried out. And we actually, sounded great.
Pretty much all, just one or two takes, I think.
Nice atmosphere and just like, and feel comfortable.
Around the corner.
Got through it, yeah.
Go into your own bed.
Yeah, good.
Someone else's if you're lucky.
Good experience, as long as it's not mine.
Go to your own bed, find someone else in it.
Yeah.
Bonus. Double. That's a double bonus, that
depends
is.
Depends who you find, you know.
Yeah, that's probably Larry Grayson. His dead body. Rotten corpse of Larry Grayson.
So how long has the Cloudesley Shovell been a thing? When did you guys get together then?
About five or six years ago, something, was it?
Six, seven years ago. We started off jamming, and then we just thought we'd learn some covers to be a bar band and make some money.
Mm.
And our inept versions of other people's songs were rubbish. No, they were okay, but we realised the jams, we could write our own inept songs and have more fun playing them.
Yeah.
Which is pretty much how it came out. We always have a bit of jamming rehearsals and that, come up with riffs and... piece them all together.
What's up next? A little ditty called Happiness Begins. Not necessarily at bedtime. We'll be right back.
Has it always been, have you always known that's what you want to do? I mean, as kids, did you play and everything? And
Yeah, pretty much. I think I've always been into playing the guitar and that. It's always been my main interest in stuff, music and, you know, playing guitar and stuff like that.
I started drums because no one else wanted to do it.
Is that right?
Yeah. Because it was not easy to pack up at the end of the night.
You started drums because nobody talked to you, so you thought you might as well.
So it's quite interesting, your drums have got a bit of a story as well.
Mungo Jerry.
How did you end up in Mungo Jerry's kit then?
An old friend of mine, luckily for me, but not so much for him, become a heroin addict.
Yeah,
he sold it for me for 70 quid, I think it was, because he needed obviously some medication.
Yes,
I guess. Anyway, that's what it's in.
He probably couldn't lift up his arms to hold the sticks or anything.
I don't think there's anything wrong with people being hooked on awful drugs, because they always end up selling you stuff
really
cheap.
Yeah.
We've done all right.
It's record.
Yeah, exactly.
Shall I just take a 10 bag for it? I've got some here. Yeah, that's where it came from. But he got it from Mungo Jerry's roadie, apparently. That's what happened. Right. Anyway, so maybe it's just a sales.
He probably bought it off the drummer because he was a smacker and sold it to him for like 20 quid or something.
Funnily enough, though, it had the original skin on it, didn't it? They've done a gig down the crypt with it.
I said to Bill, you want to change that because they're hit, you know.
That's what it is. And
I said, you want to change that? The first gig we did, it
was luckily on the last song, but it did split.
Bass drum split.
I think that's probably why, because that's what they pretty much use as a bass drum. A lot of bass drum, yeah.
Still
Reviews, I think, on the record.
Yeah, we have indeed. Yeah, there's been a lot of positive stuff.
A lot it's of been described as a psychedelic punch in the face.
Would it say, yeah,
that's pretty good.
Trippy, but at the same time brutal. I thought it was a good, bloody good analogy. That was
Phil. That was good. Good old Phil. Good chat.
Yeah, fine reviewer. That was good. Good way with words, man. Yeah,
indeed.
One of the nicest albums. Cover-wise, I've seen for a long time, actually.
Cheers, man.
Yeah. So we've taken the non-PC approach of smoking on camera because...
we all smoke at
home. We all smoke at home, which they're trying to stop.
Yeah,
dreadful. I smoke in the studio because it's a recording studio and that's what musicians do.
Jelly.
So, yeah. Now, Louis's got the album sleeve for you to have a look at here, which is... bloody marvellous, if you ask me.
A lot of you kids out there are probably wondering what this is. It's not a big piece of cardboard, but it is a big piece of cardboard. But this is basically what your granddad used to listen to before CDs were invented. It's called a record.
And you can't actually put those in CD players.
Can't,
they
won't fit. No. Too big.
Fold them a bit.
It's no good trimming off all this black stuff and just putting this bit in, because that won't work. You know, you do it.
Look at that. Nice shiny black plastic.
Shiny black.
Yeah, it truly plastic. Is a thing of beauty. Mm. Let's have a look at the poster as well. This is.
Oh, there's a free poster with this one.
Mm. This is more reasons than you could possibly need to buy this record. Absolutely, so go out and do so immediately.
A
rattle
paper at Christmas for us there. Yeah. Yeah. Throw me out wide. You've got a big, big picture of us there. Yeah. Down an alleyway. That's what you'll kind of find. Generally find us down an alleyway. Or
in alleyway, sure.
Or standing in a graveyard.
This is my personal favourite. I think this is a
space car.
Superb image.
Buzzard. Like our stance there. We've all got the same stance.
Yeah.
It's like it's rehearsed. It's rehearsed.
Yeah. Smoke bombs. Real smoke bombs. No, this is Photoshop. Yeah. Actually had young... Real we could actually have small children lighting smoke bombs for us. And
excellent. The sun shines out your arse a little bit as well.
The sun does shine out my arse on the
photo. It does, in fact, yeah.
And there's nothing nicer, really, when you've got a band playing with that kind of energy. If the snare's buzzing because the guitar's playing, it's a good thing.
Sort of, you know, it's
part of it. Of course
it is,
engineers will take out, I can hear a slight ring from when you hit the cab. That's what it sounds like, man, you know. And also, I think the drums and bass playing together, it sort of... You know, it blends together and it makes a sound.
It's such a unit.
You listen to a, you can't see a band, you don't just listen to the bass or just listen to the drums. You hear the whole, and that's the thing they say it should be recorded as well. It's all together. Things work off each other, and if there's a little bit of buzz or rattle here and there, who gives a fucking shit, man?
Oh, it's definitely great fun for me, sort of going for the authentic sound and doing it the right way, you know.
Yes.
I love that.
I think it's a shame that some bands think you have to multi-track, you know, put down drums and then do both, and then you just lose all the interaction and the energy. I mean, you know,
that's it.
You might speed up a bit as you're going, or you might play things you don't mean to play, but that's all part of the fun, man. It shouldn't, rock and roll shouldn't be a processed, you know, click track formulaic thing. It should be with balls and from the heart, from the soul, man. That's the only way to do it, you know. I wouldn't want to do it any other way.
Excellent. Well, thanks again for playing an awesome set.
It's been a pleasure.
Thanks to you, Harvey.
And make sure you see the guys if they're playing live anywhere near you, and go out and buy Check 'Em Before You Wreck 'Em.
Yeah, go and buy the album.
CD or
CD
super
and vinyl.
Vinyl.
Yeah,
go and buy it, and then you're guaranteed we'll come to a town near you very soon.
As long as you've got pies.
Bring us a couple of pies.
Like
while we're
delicacy,
a couple of beers.
Yeah, exactly. A lot of beers.
Yeah, sort it.
And get down to Broadoak Studios if you...
Yeah, and if you want to record an album that sounds exactly like this, come here.
You ain't got a chance, but...
You got a chance in hell, but come to Broadoak Studios because it's a fucking great place to make music.
It is amazing,
I'll settle up with you for that.
Highly recommended. You said you sent a check, didn't you?
Yeah. It's in the post.
It's a good place. Very good place.
That's it. Thanks again very much. Fantastic.
Been a pleasure. Thank you very much, Harvey.
Thanks, Harvey.
Good luck with the album.
Cheers.
Thank you
very much. Awesome.
Cool.
Excellent.
Brill.
Good stuff, man.
Excellent. I'll edit that down to about 15 seconds worth.
Yeah, take all the swearing
3 seconds. Like, well, take all the swearing out. It'd be down to about 5 minutes.
Here's the B-side of our single, Sports Fans. It's a number called Elementary Lemonentry Man. Ready? I live alone in a house I own, back on home. them an interest.